In the 1860s, Irish regiments covered themselves with glory in the American Civil War.
On the night before Fredericksburg, two Irish regiments were encamped on opposite sides of the Potomac River. The song Ireland Boys Hooray was a favorite with Irish emigrants, and it was sung by the northern troops as they prepared for the battle to come.
The southern troops took up the chorus, and for half an hour the two armies sang together in the darkness.
Deep in Canadian woods we met from one bright island flown. Great is the land we tread, but yet our hearts are with our own. And ere we leave the shanty small while fades the autumn day, we'll toast old Ireland, dear old Ireland, Ireland boys hooray.
Ireland boys hooray, Ireland boys hooray. We'll toast old Ireland, dear old Ireland, Ireland boys hooray.
General Robert E. Lee on the conduct of the Irish Brigade at Fredericksburg in 1862. Never were men so brave. They ennobled the race by their splendid gallantry on that desperate occasion. Though totally routed, they reaped a harvest of glory. Their brilliant, though hopeless assaults on our lines excited the hearty applause of our officers and our men.
We've heard her faults 100 times, the new ones and the old, in songs and sermons, rants and rhymes, and large some 50-fold. But take them all, the great and small, and this we've got to say. We'll toast old Ireland, dear old Ireland, Ireland boys hooray.
Ireland boys hooray, Ireland boys hooray. We'll toast old Ireland, dear old Ireland, Ireland boys hooray.
The Medal of Honor, the highest decoration awarded to members of the American Armed Forces, was instituted by Abraham Lincoln in 1861. The 202 Irish-born recipients constitute the largest group of immigrants ever to receive this award.
We see